Once the storm has come through, we begin the damage assessment process. We have folks that'll go out, visit each of the locations that are called in by our customers to identify what the cause of the outage is.
So today we mocked up a damage scenario where we had some trees come over, break the pole, and bring the conductors down to the ground. But these trees that we used today were fairly small compared to some of the larger trees that will actually do this kind of damage. Smaller trees can take, you know, 1-2 hours or so. Larger trees might take 3 or 4 hours to get that off, and then perhaps getting it off to the side of the road so we can get other line crews in here to do the work and get the road up and running for traffic is another issue.
Once the trees are cleared and the area is made safe, it's the line crews then will follow behind. We can't always just pop a new pole back in the hole. It's usually not clean enough to set another pole. So if it's nice soft clay, that's going to go much faster than rocky or ledge-filled soil. They have to pick the pole and set it nice and plumb, backfill it, tamp it down, and get it ready.
Once the new pole is set and in place, that's when the overhead line crew will show up with the bucket. They'll look to pick up the wires, restring the wires, replace transformers or other equipment that might have been damaged. In some cases, it could be quick, you know, only take a couple of hours to do. But as you get more equipment, you know, you could be upwards of 10 hours plus, depending on how complex. And then they'll look to re-energize the customers from there.